this is not Saturday Morning Science. This is just life on Space Station. I thought I'd jazz up your Saturday to show you how we do something here. And this is how we do a snack. And I'm going to eat some honey and crackers and some little loaves of bread. And I'll just show you what you have to go through in order to do that here. I'm also going to have a bag of tea. And so here we are in the service module. This is our galley table. And I just opened up a package of crackers, and I put them on that little clip with some Velcro, because a lot of our food items don't have Velcro on them, so you have to figure out how to hold them down. And this is a package of Russian breads. It's a chorny clip, so it's the dark bread. And they look like little miniature loaves. They look like a loaf that Barbie would have. So we refer to them as Barbie loaves or Barbie breads. And this is a can of meat, which is our honey. And the first thing you're going to do is take your can opener and open the can of honey. But you need to get some wipes first because it can get a little messy. So we have these packages of wet wipes and dry wipes right there on the galley table. Sometimes they're a little hard to get just one wipe out. And when you open up some of these cans, sometimes they have this nasty habit of squirt. So you want to make sure you got a wipe in your hand just in case it decides to squirt you. And when you open a can, I like to leave the lid attached because it allows you to hang on to something. So, and also, if you cut the lid off, then you got another thing floating around with sharp edges on it. So I like to just leave a little tab and leave the lid of the can attached. Now, these cans don't have any Velcro on them, and you wonder, how can you hold them down so you can eat them? And I'm using a chopstick to open up the can. And so what you do to hold your cans onto the table, you use a contact wetting angle surface tension forces. So you squirt a little water on the bottom of your can. Then I put a little blob on. And now you just stick it to the table, and there you go. It just stays there. So you don't really need Velcro if you have something without Velcro. You just stick it on using a little bit of water.
Don, is that something you got in your hand over, or did you come up with that on your own?
I didn't get this in the handover, but what I was doing was looking for a practical application for all that surface chemistry I learned in college. You know, we did a lot with surface tension and stuff. So this is a practical example of that. Now, I got a set of chopsticks that came up in the progress. I've been eating my meals with chopsticks, and I'm just showing you that here in zero gravity, you can eat your honey with chopsticks. And now I'll reach into that little sack, which I carefully cut it open in a particular way with the scissors so that you could conveniently reach in there and pull out those little Barbie loaves of bread. And then you can just stick them there in the honey, and you can reach in with your chopsticks. And the chopsticks work great for this because it keeps you from getting your fingers all sticky. And you can just pull one of those breads out, and yum, 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 you can have a snack. And then here you can reach into your package of crackers, which, again, they don't have any Velcro on them, so you use one of those clips, and the clip has Velcro, and you stick it on the side of the table. You reach in there, you grab a cracker out, and you can stick that in the honey. And again, yum, yum, yum. This is really a good snack. Now here I'm playing with my food. I know we're not supposed to play with our food, but there's some really neat surface chemistry going on here. So watch this closely. There's one of those little Barbie loaves of bread. And I pull it out. It's got a filament of honey on it. But if I let go of it, that filament of honey will suck it right back down into the can of honey. Watch that. I was fascinated with the surface tension courses here on that can of honey. And also notice you get a near parabolic profile on that honey in the can, which is what you would expect with any free liquid in the absence of gravity. And since the lid has honey stuck to it, it makes a great place to park your little loaves of bread to keep them out of the way.